Hello everybody, Dr. Carlo Oller, Medical Director at Cartersville Medical Center in Cartersville, Georgia. This video is about doctors and dress code. This article, entitled Healthcare Workers' Equipment and Dress Code, a Potential Source of Nosocomial Infection. A colleague from UKM approached me to do an interesting survey on medical students' dress code and its relationship to nosocomial infections. Have you ever wondered that you might be a source of serious infection within the hospital settings? The lab coat you are wearing every day, then you carry it back to your hotel or house, lecture theater, the stethoscope you use every day to auscultate the chest on different patients. Do you clean it before each and every examination? It's an interesting question that is posed on this blog. The second article from the UK, hospitals issue doctor's dress code. London, British hospitals are banning neckties, long sleeves, and jewelry for doctors, and their traditional white coats in an effort to stop the spread of deadly hospital-borne infections, according to new rules published Monday. Very interesting, it goes through MRSA and superbugs, and really the importance of being bare below the elbows, not to carry bacteria and infections. Let's be honest, we don't wash our coats every day. We don't change them. We're taking them home, potentially exposing our family members to nosocomial infections. Neckties, they're rarely, if ever, dry, clean, and washed. They get into our exam area, they fall into a settings where they could get infection, and then transmit infection. So it makes sense that a dress code that limits the potential for cross-infection is a good thing for patient care. In this article, the New York legislation aims to create hygienic dress code for healthcare practitioners. The New York Independent Democratic Conference has introduced a state legislation aiming to establish hygienic dress code for medical professionals practicing in New York. This includes banning neckties, banning coats, especially below the elbow policy. This other one, among medicine's freshest faces, love for the white coat. We all love it. We wanted to have it when we were going to school. But in this day and age, to protect our patients, it's definitely a potential source of infection and contamination. You can stop this video and read the article if you wish. Now, Mad Scientist Societies, dinner dance, black lab coat only. It's just a funny thing. You know, we're traditional being seen as the doctors, having the white coat, having a necktie, being well-dressed. Here's doctors in Washington, all with neckties and lab coats. One has a target signs. Definitely, we don't want to be one of those. Especially not in the emergency room setting. In the office setting, in a consultation setting, even in a meeting, it would be appropriate dress wear. Definitely, this is not the way to come to work either. No headbands, no tank tops, jerseys, and things like that. Jeans are not appropriate, sandals and whatnot. But what is appropriate? Well, this is too much. And like I described before in the articles, this is not the way to go now because of infection rates and because of the busy ER and the kind of things we do. Thanks to ER show, patients expect us to wear a green scrub or some kind of scrubs and a coat. But because of the articles I just read, even a coat is a bad idea. These are some examples of dress codes in Europe. As you can see, they're dressing their doctors in scrubs, short sleeves, to decrease contamination, decrease potential for nosocomial infection. Even kids know doctors wear scrubs and coats and masks and so on. So, it is my goal to establish a dress code here at Cartersville Medical Center. Don't worry, it'll be really easy. I have managed to have the hospital agree to wash and laundry our coats. That means you can come in with regular street clothes, change into scrubs that are monogram with the MCARE logo, and emergency medicine right on it. I will have labels to put on the coat to identify yourself. And the scrubs will be hunter green, a universal color for doctors. So, We have purchased a total of 24 something scrubs, 4 smalls, 8 mediums, 8 larges, and 4 extra larges. If you have special needs like extra tall or short or maybe another size, you can buy them, and MCARE will reimburse through the CME allowance that we get every year. They will be monogrammed with MCARE and emergency medicine on it. That means that even the mid-levels and doctors will be dressed the same. This will unify the patients that look like the medical providers are the ones dressed in green. We might not be different January 9th when we start the contract, but we will look different. And this is the start of a different year. We're going to do things differently, and a unified look for patients, a unified look for nurses and other staff to identify us is definitely a good thing. The fact that I care enough about you that I don't want you carrying your MRSA bugs home, it's a big deal, I think. And the fact that MCARE was willing to pay for the scrubs for us, I think is a good positive thing. It's hunter green color. Hope nobody hates it. It's a pretty universal color, and patients kind of almost expect doctors to be wearing green anyway. And that's it. Well, it's a brand new year, like I said. I'm excited about our changes, and this is the first of many. I hope you take this well, and that you can see the benefit for patient care and for flow through the emergency department and for your own safety. Bye-bye.